look like?
The EU could play a much more active role than it does for the moment. I think that the relations between many, many Jews in Israel is closer to European countries than it is to the United States, where they get an enormous amount of weapon and money from the US, especially weapon from the US. It's incredible. But I think that EU, you know, the personal relations are much stronger to Europe for many relations in Israel and, well, in Palestine too. And I think if Europe really took its own laws serious and then say, well, we go first and foremost for a total segregation between illegal settlements and Israel proper, so we don't deal at all with anything from the settlements. And that's not only products. That should also be education, authorities, schools, everything. You know, even if they can do it, banks. So, you know, I think that could help a lot. And that could even push the fantasy. And if you then made targeted sanctions to the most violent settlers, you know, we know who they are. We do that in all other places in the world. I wouldn't say I would go as far as we do to the other places in the world, because then we should be much more tough. If you compare to what we are doing to Russia with Kremlin, what we are doing to in Kremlin, you even have had a referendum with a vast majority in favor of Russia. But still, I think, you know, that would for me be an argument not to have sanctions against Russia for what they have done, just to be aware. I wasn't calling for that scale, but just to use many of the legal means we have already in hand, if Europe did that, saying, well, you know, we have no connections, and business has been, for instance, business, it has been warned long time ago that they could be exposed to sanctions if they are dealing with settlements. And there's a list, even if the Israelis try to postpone or stop this list at the UN on business, and this list doesn't even cover a weapon, which is strange, but this list is there. But if member states, if Europe doesn't do anything to pursue what's in it, of course, it's all the same. And my friends in Israel, and I have still quite a lot, and they called for Europe to be active, because if there's no consequences of anything Israel is doing, this de facto annexations, settlements, expansions, forced transfer, house demolition, and so on and so forth, and this clear apartheid. We have had this discussion also in the among ourselves, and I don't know if you are aware that the first description of Israel being an apartheid state came from the churches, the Palestinian churches or Middle East Church Council, already back in a document called Kairos, I could add, back in 2010 from World Council of Churches. If you look into this Kairos, you can Google it, it's quite interesting. And the other South African churches responded that it was absolutely justified to use this term. They would say it was even worse in Palestine not in Israel, but in Palestine, the discrimination based on ethnicity.